Okay guys, my no-op shopping pan has just been delayed for a little bit because I am in Caboolture, outer suburb of Brisbane, just north of Brisbane, with my daughter, my son, and Miss 13, the granddaughter. We're going to head over to this one over here. It is Salvo's, Caboolture, Queensland, and I've got to do a few more. I'll let you know how I go. And then I'm going to see if I can keep this up and going. This is all the outside of it. It's an old church. See if I can keep going. I like that church there.
Ask Richard and Matt and that.
Oh, how much are they, Dave?
What?
I need that. Oh, are they? I've got two of those. They weren't so dear. $50 each. I'd love them. I'd have loved to have to add to my collection. I've got two already. But I didn't. I think mine are the same shape. $50 each is a bit too much, though. Oh, okay, let's go see. Similar, not quite the same. But it broke to the job. Thank you.
Laura,
how's she? Yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah, go look at them. Okay, turn you off now.
There's a dress side, it's orange, red.
Seriously, there's a great deal of stuff here. This dress is lovely. Like, oh, you saw the pictures at the front. This is a beautiful dress for a larger lady, curvy lady. $60 for it. And some of their jackets was $25. Sometimes I do wonder whether they actually want to keep their stuff and not sell it at all. There's some beautiful wedding dresses here. I love old wedding dresses, but I'd say they're all very expensive as well. This one looks like an old one with the old ribbon lace. It's really tiny. Sometimes if their dresses are cheap enough like that, I will buy them $30 each. There, these are a lot of these are vintage ones, but they're just too expensive. Damn it.
Maybe not on me.
Yeah, I love jeans with holes in it, really.
They might not fit me. Oh, they have four buttons.
Button flies. So it looks like Miss 13's got a little handful there already. Okay, that was a bit of a bust. Miss 13 got the best. She got a bag of clothes for $6 and a top that she wanted. Smile. And Miss daughter got a book. I got a couple of old more Monopoly games in the back with the ones with the metal pieces, because a lot of people buy the metal pieces to make into jewellery. And I got a drawing book in the back as well, because someone's looking for drawing books to buy. So that's all I've got here. So now we're at a place, a Lifeline. Big Lifeline shed. I'd turn you around here, but it won't let me. So there's a Lifeline shed there. Miss 13's waiting for me. Fingers crossed we find something. I'll see if I can turn it around. I don't think I can while I'm using it. So I'll be back soon. Oh, once again, it wasn't great. What'd you get, Dave? What'd you pick up?
Two Doctor Who.
Show us.
That one. Yeah. And that one.
He's just starting out on this eBay selling.
And the original Star Wars
book.
Books.
I remember having this one. Where is it? This one here back in the 70s when I was a kid when it first came out.
These two are the same person has done these two.
Hopefully we'll do something.
It's done by him as well.
Yeah, Miss 13 got P.S. I Love You because I told her it's an awesome movie, but she'll be crying later. And a sequel to a book, two books I've already got. Yeah, the second into a sequel I've got.
And
also the Simpsons one, which I'll probably put with my other Simpsons bits. Anyway, that's all. It's a bit of a crap one. Go to the next one. My son has decided to take me to this pawnbroker place. Missy saw this gumball machine. She had to have 20 cents to get chewing gum. But yeah, it's got some interesting stuff in here.
Stale?
Probably been there for a year. Got all sorts of things in here. Check out the Smurfs down here. My son has decided to take me to this pawnbroker place. Missy saw this gumball machine. She had to have 20 cents to get chewing gum. But yeah, it's got some interesting stuff in here.
Stale?
Probably been there for a year. Got all sorts of things in here. Check out the Smurfs down here. Smurfs like crazy. Look at that. There are hundreds of them. Pretty cool. Mad magazines. I'm kicking myself now. I saw some Mad magazines in Op Shop somewhere last year. I didn't get them because I wasn't in the buying mindset at the time. It's a jewelry. I'm really loving this barber's stool, the chair thing.
You guys, okay, it was a really hard to choose, but after you start training,
I turned into a barber. Oh, good. Glad. Glad it wasn't wasted 20 cents. See how much these are. So we've got some of these for sale. Those book manuals are good to look out for too. The old manuals. Old weights. Weight machine. Spin one. This is not making me too dizzy. He was hanging to bring me here, so I thought I'd come here before the next workshop.
Glass sword.
Oh, glass sword. Glass sword, it's amazing someone's made that.
And the what?
Holy dolly. Megalodon tooth, the weights. All the cool vintage bits in here.
And this is all the stuff this guy's collected and put it on display.
Oh, it's really cool. I love them. Look at the cufflinks over there. What they've got in them, they're really cool. They've got an insect or something in it.
They've got old watches and pins and stuff over this side.
Oh, yeah. Old. That's all my style.
Yeah, here's some older stuff.
Oh, nice jewelry.
It's
always just this is personal collection and stuff. It's amazing. So none of that for sale. Oh, I love that ring. Big red ruby coloured garnet one at the back there in the yellow box. It's gorgeous. Oh, a collection like that. Love chairs. Yeah. I've got a set similar to that at home. I'm in storage. Very lovely, nice set.
That would be worth something. Yeah. One in the corner.
Oh, yeah.
The necklace around it.
Yeah, it's lovely that. Heading into one called City Point Op Shop in Caboolture. I haven't been to any of these before. I've been Googling them all, so see how we go. Clothing bins. Yeah, I don't really feel like that today. Display items only. Don't you love it when they get donated and they get display items only? So awesome. Oh. Look at the paper dresses. People are really good at this sort of stuff. Oh, they do the books. Why?
No, look at my hand.
What is it? All the stuff that I love is way up here. It's on display. Look at it all. Bailey. Skateboards. Vintage skateboards. No, they're all display. It smells, I must have just freshly painted in here. How cool is that? But it's actually, look at how you feel it. It's actually wire. How cool is that?
Double shooter.
Oh, then you might have to get that, David, for yourself. How much of that? You like that though? The kids would like it. Always check out the games.
Yeah, I remember when I used to have one of these.
Looking for one particular one. He wants to put an Eiffel Tower together. Hey, I'm going to turn off now. I can find something, I'll let you know. Missy used to have one like this. This has just brought back memories for her. So she thought I'd decide to get her, give it a bit of a play. Because they're not on the display. This is a beautiful, big, one of those silk rug fabric things. I've got a few in storage I can't get to, but it's a beautiful, big, gigantic one. But it's lovely. Heading into Salvo's. So we're going this time. See what we can find. I'm going to look out here on the outside table quickly. If I was in the right frame of mind and I hadn't put myself on the big band, which I need to put myself on the band, I'd be looking at everything a bit more better. I'd be going through all the clothes. But because I put myself on the band, I'm doing pretty good.
Look at the drum.
Oh, yeah. I don't know where people find all this really expensive jewellery. I'm going to get all the junky stuff and never find much that's worth anything. Yeah. I'll go have a look over there if someone's talking at the moment. I get a bit overwhelmed with these huge, huge ones because I don't know where to look at first. It's nice. Size is that? That's small. All I want is vintage, and there's no vintage here. Wedding dresses, hey? I'm going to tell if there's nothing exciting in here to show at the moment. I'll come back. Okay, heading up to the very last one, which is, I love it, another Lifeline, but it shuts in 10 minutes. So the others haven't been a great success for us. So I probably won't come make my way up here too often to Op Shop. But yeah, we'll just try out this one. Still got 10 minutes left. I'll head in there in a second. Well, that sucks. It's 10 minutes to 4. And we got to, the kids got to the door. And she shut the door on them. Said, no, we're closing now. So, yeah, they just lost out on money if there was anything for us. So we're heading back. That's the end of our day. We'll be back later to show you some stuff. Well, as you know, our Op Shopping day was fun, but not anything to write home about. The only things that I saw that I would have bought were all for display only. Laura got out a book. Bailey, the Miss 13, got a few things. And I got a Monopoly and a couple of books, and my son got some books to hopefully resell. But I thought I'd finish off the video today. So showing you my voice isn't back properly yet, but it's better. The husband's got a lung infection too now. But I want to show you something that I got. In Bundaberg, they have a tender centre where you go in and look at all the stuff people are selling, and you put in the tender amount that you would happily pay for things. So I put in, oh damn, it's in the back, a big movie book that I've got at home, but some of the pictures are missing. So I've got that. It's got all the old movie stars, but they're really huge, like a really big book. So I want to be able to pull them out one day and have them on walls when I have my vintage shop, vintage walls section eventually. And I got, Miss 16, I got her a bag that she wanted. And I also got what I'm going to show you next, which is full of jewellery. And I'll turn the camera around in a second and you can see what I got. I didn't realise when I got it. I'll talk to you about that in a second. This is the box I got. I didn't realise when I got the box that it was a pretty box like this. I'll show you. Because it was just all I could see was that part of it. And I just thought it was a cardboard box, all that was in. But it's actually a lovely hand-painted box from 2005. Someone did, and they also did the detailing around the size of it. I'm not sure if I'll keep it at this moment. I might sell it, but I just thought it was very pretty, so I thought I'd show you that. Anyway, I went through the box yesterday. It's been lined with orange, funky orange stuff. I went through the box. Now, the reason I bought this, when I saw it, and it was in a cupboard, I couldn't see it properly, it was in a glass cupboard, and what I saw was this piece here, which is an old lipstick container, but sadly the end of it's missing, so there's only that part with the mirror. It's all that's there, which is a shame. And I also saw this pink jewelry, so I knew there was some vintage stuff in it. So yesterday, I picked up yesterday morning, and yesterday afternoon me and my daughter sat down and had a look at it, and inside it we've got this vintage comb, which you open like that. So they had it back in the handbags back in the day. This one was made in Japan. It's got a lot of tarnishing happening, but it's still very pretty. Anyone who likes that type of thing, so I'll probably sell that. Most of this is actually modern costume jewelry. It's not a lot to write home about. There are a couple of really funky pieces in here though, in this section somewhere. I might just go through that first and leave the vintage stuff to last. But I'm going to try and do this one hand. It's just bags of jewelry and stuff. Some of it's broken, so I'll sell it. I'll sell it as a chunk jewelry, like costume jewelry collection. People who do jewellery recreation, these pearls, which aren't, they're only very light, they have been knotted in between, nothing fancy there. Stretch jewellery, which I'm pretty sure this is just a modern piece of jewellery because the backing doesn't look old, so it's just a modern piece. Not my type of thing. A modern choker, just a modern piece of rubbish jewellery. So once again, like I said, most of this is just junk jewelry that I went through, but in here somewhere is a couple of pieces I'd like to show you. Junk jewelry again. I think this is, I'll show that one in a minute. Junk jewelry again. There is something I want to show you in here that was a bit, someone might like. It was pretty funky. This was quite cute. It's actually got a I think this is the one that's got the one of these, I'm not sure if that one has got a earrings or necklace with it. I don't know if it's that one or the other one, but there's just something that says, I don't know, Japan. But there's Avon jewelry, there's all sorts of boring stuff in here, and I'm sure Avon jewelry will be a collector's item in Australia eventually. What I'm trying to find is hiding, here it is, this huge fish. So it's a piece of costume jewelry someone might like, and the fish tail moves. I don't know what brand it is. I didn't actually look at it. I don't think it's stamped with a brand. It's probably one of those ones you get from Louisa or, I can't think of the other names, but all those sort of places. So yeah, so that was quite funky. Maybe you could put a, I don't know, maybe not. I was going to say you could put a diffuser thing in there to keep your body smelling nice. But I thought that was nice. I'll be selling that by itself or with this one. A lovely elephant as well. And I think that was a L'Equipe or a Diva or something piece of jewellery. So yeah, it was nothing really super fun to write home with. Shark attack necklace, pretty beads. This is actually quite pretty. I don't think I'll try and open it. It comes with some earrings as well. It's like the hippie beads, and it comes with what were they called? I don't know. It weren't called hippie beads back then, but they come with the little earrings. So someone's probably sat there and made all this. That was quite pretty. Small junk jewelry coming out, but I'll show you the nice stuff in a second. I'm not sure if this was old or whether it's new. It's got a sort of old design, and they're all glass beads. They're not plastic beads. What puts me off is these shiny bits at the end. Whether that's vintage or not, it's sort of like one of those pieces I can't tell. But I know it's an older piece because... No, I don't think it's an older piece. I think it's just made to look old. But anyway, it's glass, not plastic. Beading in that. Just trying to find the pieces I want to show you. I'll leave them over there. Okay, so the pieces I want to show you were... it's actually quite funky. It's probably 1980s one, I think, or 90s. It's got the older clasp on it. So someone might like that. It's only plastic, but it's quite cute. In here also had an old fan, those fold-up fans. It's a nice design, the Hawaiian hula girl on the front of it. See the hula girl? It's Hawaii, so someone's been to Hawaii and brought that home. Then there was these are the pink ones, are the ones that I saw. My daughter, she's 31, she hates all the vintage stuff. She's a minimalist. She does not like anything that's cluttering space and it's not useful. So my stuff gives her eye twitches all the time. But I thought this was really pretty, beautiful colouring, lovely old clasp on it, nothing fancy, but it's nice old clasp on it. So that was one of the vintage pieces that was in the box that I saw. Then there was this, it's no clasp on it, it's just a chunky, oh yes there is, it's an older clasp. Not old, but older, probably 80s or before. But it's quite nice, only heavy plastics, nothing fancy. Then we got another one of these three-strand necklaces with that type of clasp on it. So that's another nice one. Way too close for you to see, probably. Oh, my arm's starting to break. Okay. Then there was this lovely piece of milk glasses, the second piece of milk glass necklace I found recently. That will be selling. And I got these two funky owl earrings in here. So anyone who likes owls, probably love those. And these ones, I had two of these ones in here too. These are just more modern ones. That sort of style. One day I hope to hit the jackpot and find a $3 bangle that's worth thousands or something. There's a lovely old brooch, which I'll probably give to my sister, but it has been had glue replaced in that spot, so it's really got one missing, but no stamping sadly. I think this is the one it had. This is the one I was talking about before. I think this is vintage. It's got a vintage clasp on it. These are not plastic, they're all solid stone, glass, whatever. They also came with the pendant, so it's a nice little set, came together. It has no maker's marks or anything on it that I could see. But it's not a modern one, because you see, hang on, let me have a look at that clasp. Yeah, the clasp is not a modern one like we have now. The parrot clasp is an older clasp. And funky looking piece of, my daughter was like, oh my goodness, I'd wear that little tassel thing with a little glass bead on it. She's not into it at all. Painted beads, got a special name to it. And this would have been a lovely necklace, but it's just no good for anything except for reusing the beads because it's broken. So it's just all glass beads, which someone might find useful. And this one was one I was really, really wowed about. It looks like to me someone's made it in the 1970s. It's all copper and brass. Not sure. Try to open it up. Can you open that up for me? Can you hold that up for me?
Natural yogurt.
Hey, I'm talking about a video. Can you hang on for a second because I'm in the middle of a video? We're going to talk about that. My daughter's in the bus cleaning out our fridge. She's, like I said, flown up to visit us. I might not have told you that. Anyway, it's a beautiful handmade necklace, copper and brass, I think. Is it copper and brass?
Yeah.
Yeah. Which I'm sort of debating whether to keep because it's so funky and original and it's got this. Last one, so it's a beautiful handmade one. Excuse the background sound, doesn't matter how many times I tell them I'm doing a video, nobody listens. Anyway, because he's out there looking at the generators on, and we're just powering the bus because we're staying in an unpowered site here at the moment and heading south tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed my video today. Hopefully I'll be able to talk a bit better next time. Here we are, I've got another one on this side. See, I can't, no privacy. Been in the car trying to do it, I still can't get privacy. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. I'm trying to get my bravery up. I just went off for some reason to get my bravery up so I can go into the shops more often with my camera and not let people worry me when they're looking at me strangely. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching and see you again soon. Bye.